mild violence, and strong language. Parental guidance is advised.
Ghana in 1995. The infamous Kumipreko demonstration in Accra and also resonating across the country over high cost of living and generally poor economic conditions set the tone for a series of civil defiance during the Jerry Rawlings era.
The policies that the government has been implementing are policies that do not find favor with the general mass of our people, and that the mass of the people of this country have been systematically impoverished during the period of Rawlings' rule.
Among the activists then were Dr. Charles Rekubrobe, Kwesi Pratt, Dr. Nyahu Tamaklu, Kweku Baku, and a host of others.
Started in Accra here. We then went to all the 10 regional capitals. Very interesting at that time. We visited all the 10 regional capitals. Kumasi one was very notable. That's what I really want to stress on, because that was really a massive demonstration.
The issues, like in the 1920s, 1930s and 1940s, were similar, even though those were targeted at the colonial establishment that was oppressing the people. More than two decades on, another generation is here.
If organizations like us, the Economic Fighters League, don't come out and guide the process, what we might see is a revolution dotted by senseless violence. We are not looking for senseless violence. We are looking for the problems to be resolved. We want water, we want education, we want infrastructure, we want things to work.
Ernesto Yeboah is Commander-in-Chief of the Economic Fighters League, a young revolutionary radical Nkrumahist movement mobilizing people at the grassroots to achieve economic freedom for all.
Revolution, the change that we all need. Black Africa must unite and fight for economic freedom.
In 2016, this movement began and has since then been at the forefront of championing several social and economic causes.
We are not representing ourselves, we are representing the vast majority of our people who have been let down by the system.
Drop the chamber, make the ghetto youth get a place to sleep, holy chamber.
Incensed Ghanaians in July 2019 expressed their disgust at a decision by Ghana's parliament to construct a new 450-seater parliamentary complex expected to cost $200 million in a hashtag drop that chamber.
Drop the chamber, make the ghetto youth get a place to sleep, holy chamber.
Parliament won't sit under trees one way or the other.
We don't need any discussion on this. Drop that chamber.
Ernesto Yeboah and other members of the Economic Fighters League were arrested and manhandled on July 5 when they led a group of young people on a march to Parliament over the controversial proposal.
You will molest me, you will kill me, you cannot restrain us from saying what we have to say. Drop that chamber.
Did I have to go to Parliament, for instance? Did I have to go to Parliament and scream on our representatives to drop that chamber? Was it a national priority? I didn't have to do that. I didn't. But it was because they are not listening to us. It is because we have a non-functioning democracy. It is because they don't feel accountable to us.
After the agitations, however, Ghana's parliament dropped the planned project aimed at building a new chamber. The Parliamentary Service Board, in a statement, noted Upon reviewing representations made to it by well-meaning Ghanaians, it had accordingly taken the development of a new chamber block out of its present agenda. But that would not be the first time any member of a group would be arrested.
I can't breathe! I can't breathe!
I can't breathe!
I can't breathe!
June 9, 2020.
Free Ernesto!
No!
Free Ernesto!
No!
If you are going to organize such an event, you need to notify the police within 5 days. We did that, and then the police now came and told us that they were not aware. Their superiors have told them to come and arrest us.
I can't breathe!
Young people during the heat of a COVID-19 pandemic mobilized in Ghana in solidarity with the family of 46-year-old George Floyd, who was murdered during an arrest by a white officer in the United States of America.
A hungry mob is a hungry mob. Arena fall, but it don't be tough. A yata yuk, but you'd not enough. You're gonna dance to jam music.
The rise in youth voices and activism has not been limited to the economic fighters only. On October 7, 2019, students of a Ghana School of Law poured onto the streets to demand reforms in legal education following mass failure at the bar exams.
There are so many things that are wrong with the system. And if we don't make a conscious effort to fix some of the wrongs, we would have failed our generation.
That's right.
Because we are seeking to be lawyers and to bring about change.
Yeah, man.
And so today, don't think that we are marching in vain.
Politicians are the strong in the world. Destroying our planet Earth.
The protests turned violent at the Jubilee House. Some protesters were assaulted by police, but the young people were relentless.
This is what happened to me. I did nothing. I just went and bought water. And they shot me. I was trying to tell someone to look at it, whether I'm hurt or not. He was trying to arrest me.
But that would yield some results.
We went to parliament, we got audience with the president, and a lot of recommendations have come out. We expect that particularly the report that emanated from parliament will be implemented wholesale. The parliament recommended that, for instance, the fees of remarking, if you fail one paper, you have to pay 3,000 cedis to order a remarking. That has to be reduced drastically to 500 cedis.
And the new Chief Justice, Kwesi Enin-Yeboah, admits reforms are inevitable.
The General Legal Counsel will continue to work more closely with National Accreditation Board to ensure the review and development of the curricula, method of instruction, and the admission procedures of all the approved universities running the LLB program.
I am a teacher by profession, and I have teaching at heart. It's my passion, and I want GES to be fixed. I want Ghana Education Service as a whole to be fixed.
I have come to meet Michael Owusu-Efriye, alias Teacher Kwejo, a teacher, a comic actor, and a content creator. He has several thousands of followers on social media.
I've taught for almost 4 years now. I went into teaching, then I saw that one or two things are not going on well. As a teacher, it's my concern, like, to bring it to public for people to come on board so that we get on board and fix some of the things that needs to be fixed. So that's what motivated me to come out with a fixed GES, because it's been like over 2 years that they changed the curriculum, or they introduced the new curriculum, and textbooks has not been provided, not a single textbook, but we are still in class teaching. What are we teaching? Why are the children learning? So as a teacher, I felt that. Looking at some of the structures at the rural areas, I mean, in the deplorable states, which human beings are not supposed to be sitting in there to learn. Because this is not some kind of work that we are doing. We are working with the brain. You are teaching someone, you are imparting knowledge. The person is supposed to understand. And you just can't get up from your house, just go and sit in class and learn. It involves a lot, like your preparation, how prepared is your mind. It's a whole lot. So for teaching and learning to be effective, they need to get, I mean, a structure that human beings can be inside and learn.
Yeah.
Because education na ye basa enye sei na ye penu say anhwanka ebia na semaba ebia na semaba ntiye ye nu ye o na teacher kwedu bia sembebo sembebo
sembeba. Beyond the social media activism, he is using music to amplify his message.
It's a gradual process from somewhere to somewhere. Maybe it might take long, but I believe and I hope it will reach a point that we are expecting. Because when you talk about education, it's not my private property. Ghana education belongs to us all. So if you join hands, if you are a right thinking person, definitely you will feel something, then you will join. So I know definitely, hopefully, one day, we will achieve what we want.
Education ye the assemble bow. The textbooks ye the assemble bow. The lesson notes to the assemble bow. The GS for the assemble bow.
Teacher Kojo's campaign has come at a time the social media environment is buzzing with hashtags and aggregation of young voices demanding wide ranging reforms.
Full price day high, doom sauce still day. Don't like your wahala, I go busy on another day.
From a simple hashtag started by a tweet freak, Kali J, Fix the Country has crystallized into a strong force, a mass of young people advocating for themselves. Not even attempts by the state through the police could stop a determined bunch from demanding their due.
Tell me where we're gonna run to. After making our motherland a better place to live, tell me where we're gonna run to. When them say we have to pay for the oxygen we breathe, answer me now, Mr. Big Man. You know this day everybody want to go run go for
it. If we're saying let's fix unemployment, it is not just about creation of jobs, no. You have to look at the energy generation capacity. You're supposed to look at the quality, the skill sets that our labor force is going to have. So it touches on education as well. Now, you cannot have a wealthy population if you're not healthy. So then you have to look at your healthcare system. So in tackling just one issue, which is unemployment, you're looking at 4, 5, 6 other categories that you can factor this into. So we try to stay away from limiting it into itemized points, that this is what we want to have fixed. No, we are saying we need the entire country to be fixed, because like I said, all of this is interconnected.
For several weeks they have played their game on social media, and it is no surprise the Fix the Country movement has grown into such a force, spilling over and breaking barriers.
Social media has played a very key role of connecting people over wide spaces of territories, yes. So it has been a very key tool, and we find out that with a change in time, protest and activism like this have taken a new dimension, in that rather than localize it to certain particular places, it has gone across borders. So it's become an international phenomenon right now. Characteristic of that would be with the Fix the Country demonstration, yes. Initially, it was supposed to be a march that was concentrated or limited to just Accra. But with social media, has actually broke bounds, it's gone international.
And the Wednesday, August 4th Fix the Country demonstration, which saw thousands of young people pour out onto the streets, was a clear sign. Jobs, corruption, health systems, education were all on the minds of the agitating crowd.
No job, my brother. There is no job. We need job. We don't want cathedral. You don't understand? We need job, Mr. President. Wake up! Wake up! Oh, now we are like wounded lions. My brother, we are suffering. But I can't go and sue. You understand? As a good patriotic citizen like me, young boy like me, youth, I can work. We need work. Mr. President should give us work and stop building that cathedral. That cathedral will not do anything to us.
So he said that they need...
One more thing. We need justice for Kaka.
Since he was able to tell the late president to fix Ghana, to fix the economy, we are telling him to fix Ghana for us. We are tired. We cannot move. The youth, we are suffering. President Nana Akufo-Addo Dankwa, fix Ghana. That is what we want.
We are suffering.
There's no more hospital, there's no more schools. We are suffering. If you go to hospital, there's no bed. There's no bed for hospital. So we want all Ghanaians to be part of Article 71. We are suffering. The Ghanaian youth has no future in Ghana here. We are all suffering.
Ghana education service needs to be fixed. That is my worry. That is the place that needs to be fixed. I hold a master's degree in education administration. My salary is not up to 2,500. I'm taking on 1,800, which is not fair enough. They need to change the system. Curriculum are out, but the books are not in for them to be used as an instructional material to be teaching. Teachers are suffering at the various areas in the villages.
We are against the bad leadership of this nation, the bad governance of this nation. Nowadays, our church members, when they come to church, they can't give offering. They can't pay their tithe because all our members are broke. There are no jobs in this our nation. That is why I have joined this demonstration.
The activists want urgent reforms. Key on that is a need to overhaul the existing 1992 constitution.
In the Sakawa 1992 constitution, we have gathered 1 million signatures and names of Ghanaians who believe that the 1992 constitution should be abolished.
Here in Timin, Tina Krom Habium, na Emebunia Waha, Ube Uye University, na Ulu Bistepe, Ube University, na Waya useless. We want to tell them, sir. Genara assassini era bote de maye bocha na na lu shebu jeto etubele oso adume si abale ya foso ni dia kwasu kotokere banene afasa menkuya.
But there were many other young people outside the demonstration who equally feel detached from governance. They are equally frustrated, but social media has given them a voice.
Right now in school, I'm always thinking, so when I'm done with school, what am I going to do? There are no jobs, so why am I in school in the first place? Sometimes I just think about stuff like that and I'm so confused, and sometimes I feel like just screaming, seriously. I don't really know what to do. And I hear people saying that after national service, that's when you know how hard Ghana is, and I'm just scared. I'm terrified, and I don't see the government doing anything at all about this. It is just horrible, like seriously.
I have come to the University of Ghana to meet visiting professor and professor of technical and professional communication at the University of Houston downtown, Professor Godwin Agboka. He speaks about the sudden interest in young people in matters of governance today and the subsequent agitations.
Historically, young people have not necessarily been interested in matters of the state. But I think they are now because of some of the prevailing conditions in society. Of course, I believe they are hungry, fundamentally. And but then if you look at it, the political class has failed the youth. So if you go to the Arab Spring, for example, as late as sometime in December 2010, there was what we call the Yasmin Revolution in Tunisia, which gave rise to the Arab Spring, you know, sort of the pro-democracy uprisings in Tunisia, Libya, Egypt, and Morocco. And so if you look at the role of the youth over there, they were tired about the corruption, the lack of education and the opportunities, the underemployment and unemployment over there. So that gave rise to that. So the activism you see today is a function of the societal problems that we see. I don't think it's necessarily an interest in matters of the state, but then it's because they're hungry, so they obviously want to call for some change within society.
Social media, he says, has created a huge platform of influence for these young activists to sustain their campaign.
anyone can go on social media now because they have a phone, they have a tablet, they have a smartphone. So they go on there, they post something on there, and then they make some noise. Now, when the Mahama administration was in power, Yvonne Nelson and her group of people in the arts industry, they were able to mobilize. And this was quite effective. I think that mobilization and that campaign was one of the critical factors that led to the loss of power as far as the NDC government was concerned. Now, Occupy Ghana also undertook some, how did they mobilize? They went on social media. So what they did was that they have a tag and they keep on sharing and all of that. So to mobilize groups of people, social media becomes a platform because it's cheap. Anyone can actually go on there. You don't have to have any huge level of education to be able to do that. So from that angle, yes, Fix the Country is the clearest manifestation of what we are talking about. If you look at it, I mean, Ernesto and his group of individuals who think that things have to change in the country began something. This has actually picked up, and then it's all over the place. I think, of course, they can go on radio and TV, but those will not be as effective as going on social media because everyone is there. It's democratic. It's a grassroots approach to doing that. So I think it's about the most effective you can find because of the leverage and the opportunities that it offers to people from all walks of life.
What then is the future of activism and the voices of today? Is this the means to an end or an end in itself?
One thing I keep saying, if someone do not make a step, others won't follow. We are enjoying freedom now, right? Someone fought for it. Someone stood up. Someone was jailed. People were killed before you came to enjoy this freedom. So I'm also trying to do something so that the next generation will come and enjoy.
When we say fix the country, what has been their responses? Fix yourselves. And even beyond that, when we have said fix the country, they have been annoyed with us. They have even shot at us. What they did at Deidre was their response to fix the country. I mean, how wicked, how murderous can you be as a state? They are simply telling us, I mean, if you sit back and watch, they are simply saying that we won't fix the country. So when you do this, why won't we grow in our numbers? Why won't the numbers multiply? Why won't we, have more entrenched bases to remain? If they allowed us on the 9th of May, I'm sure by now things would have whittled, would have been talking about other things. But Fix the Country has trended. So why? So oppression is not the response to a people who are interested in getting a better future.
After the August 4 demonstration, the Fix the Country movement says it is replicating the protest in many other parts of the country.
These conversations around fixing the country and the issues we've been raising have been in the public domain for almost 4 months now. So I'm not particularly expecting that the demonstration must provoke a reaction from them. A lot of people do. But I do think the way in which the issue should be reacted to should even start and predate the demonstration. So we did not see that. And I'm not expecting that they're going to change rhetoric around this. The president has barely spoken about this issue. So it's not going to surprise me. We're continuing to do what we want to do. Because we've always said from the very beginning that the conversation we want to have is with the people of Ghana themselves. Our hope is to be able to do it in all 16 regions. That is the plan. But one of the things we're also very mindful of in doing this plan is also has to be very sensitive to public health concerns as we're moving into the regions. And perhaps the way in which the decision may come would be to prioritize regions where they have low cases and that community transmission is at its lowest. And that might inform the order in which we go without any particular choosing places based on, large congregation of people and things like that. That's the process we want to do. We didn't say we wanted to fix Accra. This is what this is not about. This is about the country. We can only understand what these other people are saying. And a lot of them who are offline, we can only understand if we get into those communities and try to mobilize them and have the same conversation and opportunities for engagement that we have provided Accra. Tell me where we're gonna run to after making our motherland a better place to live. Tell me where we're gonna run to when them say we have to pay for the oxygen we breathe. Answer me now, Mr. Big Man. You know this day everybody want to go and go off arena. Simple.
clothes, give me love and give me shelter, shelter.
So the young people have spoken. This is their time, they say. And on the basis of what has been over the last few years of youth activism, something will change. Never mind the gulf in generational gap between 1995, when the Kumipreko protest movement was such a force.
It is a summons we have issued to the Ghanaian youth to rise up and be counted in this nation's hour of need.
Hey!
If for nothing at all, these young people say they are poised to take the fight to the elites, those who have oppressed them for so long. They want their compatriots to rise and be counted. Komla Adum for the assignment.
Most beautiful ladies, introducing Kwansuma, Seto, Arama, Wedega, Manu, Nana, Tero, Safua, Efua, Esi, Akosia, Ekia, Teya, Tama, Dede, and Enfojo. 16 bevies of beauty, 16 culturally inclined ladies, bold, beautiful, and assertive, ready to face the world. Who is your favorite contestant? Keep your votes coming in for them by dialing *713*13# and follow the prompts, or download the GMB Reality app on Google Play Store or Apple App Store and vote for your favorite. Make sure to not miss the live performance shows this and every Sunday at 8 p.m. right here on TV3, Ghana's most beautiful, rediscovering true beauty. Bang away, go!
GMB 2021 shows Sundays at
8 p.m.
and repeats Fridays at 3 p.m. and is sponsored by Lavon's Tomato Mix, Camel Now from Carex,
Freedom from Casaprecon,
GTP, Darling Lemon Drink,
Airtel Tigo's Big Time Bundles,
Lufat,
Deluxe Acrylic Paint, Heaven Black Mosquito Spray and Coil, and Napa Mackerel,
Geisha, Close Up,
Ayo Insurance, and supported by
Ready Camera?
Perla Mundi is a renowned Ghanaian media personality and women's advocate. She is passionate about social issues and takes exceptional interest in telling life-changing stories.
Can you believe through this Ababoya, I've been able to complete the University of Cape Coast?
Welcome to Asin Kushia. This is actually the cleanest city in Ghana.
Life is not a competition. Keep to the pace.
Action.
Welcome to the Day Show, guys.
The Day Show unravels life-threatening stories.
Before they can steal more babies, they need dead bodies to be showing parents that your baby is dead.
The passion, the fun, and sometimes not so very pleasant moments.
Yes, I have suicidal thoughts and homicidal thoughts.
Tell your story to inspire. After all, everyone has got one.
The Day Show with Berla Mundi now shows on Thursdays at 9 p.m. and repeats on Saturdays at 3 p.m. on TV3.
la 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 la